by now you must have already encountered some errors in your code. So if I execute this statement, it will show me an error saying syntax error, end of line while scanning string literal. So I have left a apostrophe here. I have corrected it, but if I don't write it, it will throw me an error calling syntax error. So syntax error is nothing but the errors that come when your syntax is not correct, meaning that you must have written something incorrectly in your code. It's not a runtime error, it's a syntax error. So this is an error. This is a type of exception because this is not a syntax error. In runtime, I have written some random value of a variable and I wanted to see the value of it. So it says name error. This is not defined. So this is a type of exception, meaning that I have not defined it and then I am trying to get the value of it. So when Python started running that code, it found an error. Okay, so let's understand it clearly through this example. We have a concept of called try and except, wherein if something happens in the try chunk of code, this syntax will execute the except chunk of code. So it's similar to if else, but it operates only when the try chunk of codes encounters an error. So this is how you tackle errors. So this is the syntax. You try to do some operations here in the try chunk. You do your operations here in the except. You have, if there is an exception, then execute this block. Else, if there is no exception, then execute this block. Okay, so this is the syntax, which is similar to if else, but it is based on errors that you may encounter while runtime of Python. Okay, so here I have written try print floating. In the except chunk, I have written error could not print floating. This chunk will check for any exception that is there in this code and then execute this statement. Okay, so if I encounter any problem in executing this statement, only then this statement will be executed. And if there is no problem in executing this statement, that is there is no exception, this chunk will be executed. So let's print it. Okay, so as you can see, there was no error in while I executed this statement. So it has printed floating, and in the except chunk, it did not print this statement and it went directly to the else statement and then printed this statement. Now let's see what happens when we try to induce an error in the try statement. So I have written one variable name which I have not defined earlier. Now this will throw me an error. This try statement will throw me an error. I expect this code to go to this loop and print this. Let's see if that happens. It has encountered some error and then it has printed error could not print floating. So this is the utility of the try except statement. Now let's move to another keyword in Python called finally. The use of it is demonstrated in this example. So if we write try print execute try statements, and then I'm asking Python to execute this statement, and then whatever be the result, finally you do this. So this code block will be executed whether there is an error in the previous statement or not. So this statement will anyway be executed. So this has executed execute try statements and then always execute finally code blocks. So this has written that also. Let's see another example wherein we have merged try, except and finally, all the three of them. So let's see what the utility of this kind of structure is. So let's say I have defined two variables, A and B. A is an integer and B is a float kind of an object. So let's execute this. Okay, A and B are assigned now. Now I'm just trying to write the print type. So this is a function which will print the type of any object that it is supposed to do. Here I have written print A comma type A. So it will print the value of A and the type of A. In the except statement, I have written print B and type of B. In the finally statement, I have written print type printed. So what this is supposed to do, let's execute this. It has gone to the try statement first, and then it has printed the value of A and the type of A. And then it did not go to the except block because there was no exception. So it directly went to the finally block. So finally is saying, finally is basically saying to Python that whatever happens, finally do this. So it has printed type printed. Now let's see if we try to induce an error in the try statement. So this will throw me an error because I have written a random variable which is not defined previously. So it should go and print the type of B and the value of B. Okay, let's see. Yeah, so it has printed it out.